The contents of this work, including but not limited to the accuracy of events, people, and places depicted, opinions expressed, permission to use previously published materials included, and any advice given or actions advocated, are solely the responsibility of the author, who assumes all liability for said work and indemnifies the publisher against any claims stemming from publication of the work. All rights reserved. Copyright 2021 by Amber M. O'Hara. No part of this book may be reproduced or transmitted, downloaded, distributed, reverse-engineered, or stored in or introduced into any information storage and retrieval system, in any form or by any means, including photocopying and recording, whether electronic or mechanical, now known or hereinafter, invented without permission in writing from the publisher. Dorrance Publishing Company presents Princess Tiffany, Adventures on the Farm by Amber M. O'Hara. Digitally narrated using the voice of Kellie Mitchell. Chapter 1. Why must I play outside? Tiffany, screamed Jolene as she held the front door open. I told you to get outside. I truly don't understand why I should go outside. Does she not know that there are bugs and other such crawly things out there? I would much rather stay here and nap on the couch, Tiffany thought. Tiffany, you see, was a very pampered tiny Yorkie puppy who thought she was a princess and had yet to realize she now lived on a farm. A very large farm, she would come to find out. Jolene had traveled to England to stay with an old friend, who at the time was caring for Tiffany. What a lovely surprise, Jolene thought, and before she was to fly back home, Jolene adopted Tiffany and brought her back from England as a gift for Maisley, her 15-year-old daughter. Tiffany had been raised just outside London, England, and had enjoyed a very luxurious life. Tiffany was used to being walked around the city on a rhinestone studded leash. Tiffany enjoyed her walks through the park, where she would see other dogs playing together. Every once in a while, she would see a horse pulling a carriage for people to see the city of London. While out shopping, her caretaker had a special purse that Tiffany fit in. Tiffany loved being carried around in that purse. Yes, Tiffany thought she was a princess, that is, up until that long, dreadful plane ride to this huge open country, with an overwhelming smell. Jolene had now given up screaming at the pampered pup, and was stomping across the room towards the couch where Tiffany lay sleeping in the sun. If you aren't going on your own, I'll give you some help, Jolene said under her breath, as she lifted Tiffany up and carried her to the door. Jolene opened the front door and placed Tiffany on the front step. If I must, Tiffany thought. The sun is out, and the wind had changed direction, so the smell was not as stinky as the last time she'd been forced outside. Chapter 2. An Adventure Off the Front Step. If they wanted her out of the house, she would gather her courage and see what all the fuss was about. Tiffany hopped off the step into the grass of the front yard. From there she stepped carefully. She did not know what might be crawling around in the grass. Not so bad, she thought. As she walked Tiffany through the grass, she heard birds chirping in the tree next to the house, and she saw a squirrel jump from branch to branch. As she walked, she could see three large shining silver buildings in front of her. I wonder what those are. They don't look like the house I live in, or any building she had seen on her walks in the city. Tiffany ventured closer to these shining buildings, and with each step, they grew in size, making her feel very small. When she was closer, she realized they weren't houses at all. They were round with pointy tops. Odd, she thought. As Tiffany looked around, she saw lots of small pieces of yellow corn on the ground. As she walked closer, a squirrel jumped down and grabbed some of the corn, gave her a curious look, and ran away. If it's good enough for a squirrel, she thought. Of course, she would taste one, and as soon as she bit into it, yuck! It was hard as a rock and not very tasty. She spit out the corn immediately, and as she did, a man walked up. Oh, she thought, I recognize you. You come in the house sometimes. The man bent down and picked her up. Well, hey there, little one, he said. What are you doing around these grain bins? This isn't food for you, he chuckled. Tiffany liked to be carried around, and so she wasn't upset with the big man picking her up.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.